Hi, this is Naren Reddy from Narayana Technologies. So today's our topic is introduction to Linux. Linux is the clone of Unix operating system. So initially the Linux was developed by a young student named as Linus Torvalds at the University of Helsinki in Finland. So Linux kernel version 1.0 was released in 1994. Linux is developed under the GNU publications, nothing but GNU is nothing but General Publishing License, and its source code is freely available. So this source code can be used by anybody else, and they can be buy and they can use according to their requirement. Now, why Linux? Linux is it's a completely open system. So it's not only executable, of Linux operating system, its complete source code is also is a complete open system. So that is the reason. So anybody also, any organizations, people can buy this open system of Linux operating system, and they can be changed according to their requirement. Next, it is a stable operating system. That is, the crash of an application is very less comparatively with some other operating systems. It is most reliable operating system. It comes with the Linux operating system. Along with the Linux operating system is providing the complete development environment like C compiler, C++ compilers, Fortran compilers, Java compilers. Like this type of compilers is providing with the Linux operating system, Qt, TCL, TK toolkits, and scripting language also is providing along with your Linux operating system. The Linux operating system is also providing very good networking facility to share your CPU or modem and etc. The sharing, whatever the Linux operating system hardware resources and software resources can be shared along with some other users through the networking, because it is having very good networking facility. The Linux operating system is also providing various types of servers such as web servers. So web server is nothing but Apache Tomcat web server is providing along with your Linux operating system. It is also consist the Linux along with your Linux operating system is providing FTP is nothing but file transmission protocol server is also providing along with your Linux operating system, and is also providing some of the gateway software is also providing along with your Linux operating system. Firewalls are nothing but the type of software. So is a software is firewall software is also providing along with your Linux operating system. Proxy servers, DNS servers is also providing along with your Linux operating system. So that is the reason the Linux operating system is not only with the operating system features, it is also consists development environment features, it is also consists the servers, list of servers, it is also consists some of the compilers and scripting languages is providing along with your Linux operating system. So that is the reason that Linux is one of the most powerful operating system in the world. Next, the Linux operating system consists majorly three components. That is nothing but kernel is nothing but is related to the operating system. Next, standard utilities and shell programming. The Linux operating system is also consists some standard utilities and shell programming features. And it is also consists of some of the tools and other software is providing along with your Linux operating system. These are the major three components is providing along with your Linux operating system. Now, if you let's observe that Linux operating system architecture. So where we have hardware, then kernel, shell program, tools and other software user. So the hardware is controlling by the kernel. Kernel is nothing but is a kind of a DLL software, is a system operating system related features which is controlling the hardware. So kernel is an interface software between user and hardware. Shell is nothing but, so shell is provide cell is a takes list of commands from the user and communicating with kernel to interact with the hardware. So shell is which takes the list of commands from the user and executing them through the kernel. And the Linux operating system also consists some of the tools like Qt, TCL, TK. These are some set of tools is providing by the Linux operating system, and other softwares called as some development related softwares, and some other like C or C++, Fortran, Pascal, Java. This related softwares is also providing along with your Linux operating system. So this is the entire architecture of the Linux operating system here. So users, if you like this video, please like and subscribe